Our first fantastic speaker tonight is Shami Kuthis. Shami is a Dubin Fellow, an MPAID candidate here at the Kennedy School, and an MBA candidate at the Stanford Graduate School of Business. Shami was raised in Bangladesh, an MIT-educated environmental engineer. She is passionate about international development and plans for a career addressing poverty challenges using business, technology, and design. Her talk is titled Design Thinking for Everyone.
What you need to prototype. And after your prototype, you need to iterate. You need tested, and from your testing, you need to know how to improve your prototypes or what prototypes to discard, and you have to repeat the steps again. So I'm just going to share an experience, and all of this was theoretical for me. I had some experience with design at MIT, but again, it was a class, I got a grade, I was happy. But I think I flipped last year when I finally actually used it for something useful. Oh. The process doesn't look like a little beautiful diamond that looks like that. So yeah, you need to be very comfortable with confusion of uncertainty and ambiguity. And that's just how it works. So this is a design brief / design challenge. This is what you get when you start a design process. You have a big open-ended challenge. Okay. So you have a big open-ended challenge, and you know that's how you start with observation, you start ideating. And for us, this was when I was working in Bangladesh. The challenge was, Bangladesh is one doctor for 3,500 people. This is one of the worst ratios in the world. But again, this is on average. In the cities, it's much better. So in the rural areas, it's much worse. So on average, it's about 40,000 to 50,000 people who have access to the doctor. And typically people, so Dr. Doma live in rural areas, there are no schools, no electricity, they just congregate in urban areas. So most people just get treatment from these rural medicine shops. So our challenge was, how do you connect rural patients to all these doctors who want to sit in the city? So first we began with observe, so these are all pictures from my design team back home. Some of them are me, some of them are my colleagues. Again, the first step begins with observation. And everyone in my design team, including myself, urban born, urban bred, many of us studied outside. We have very little idea of what rural life is, rural healthcare is. And this was, I think, the hardest thing for us to really empathize and sit and observe and understand. We spent hours and hours just, so these are pictures from marketplaces, this is where a typical medicine shop would look like. This is where people get health care. So we didn't go with questionnaires. We just went and sat. We just went and sat and waited until people forgot we were there. Because that's when you start to see how naturally people behave. That's because what people say and what people do are very different things. We had homestays, we lived with families, we dressed down. I wouldn't dress like this. We didn't wear sneakers, we wore like sandals. So there's a lot of thought when you go into a field to observe that you need to really blend in and not be obvious to people. Then you go back to your office, you have all these millions of observations, and you go back and you ideate. And you'll see whenever the design thinking comes up, you see these thousands of postscript things. That's basically you have an idea and you just keep posting it on the wall. And one of the things that's in the literature and just, is trying to be visual. That's a very core part of trying to be creative. It's very unnatural. You think it's like, you need to learn how to draw, but it's not. But again, when you force yourself to do that, you see a different part of your brain being activated. So, we observed, we ideated, we came up with lots of ideas, and then we have to move to prototype. We made an app that the rural healthcare provider would use when a patient came to him. He would put in the information, send a call to a call center in the city, so the doctor would get the information in real time, could talk to the patient, could talk to the medicine person in the village, and then prescribe something, either medication or what the next course of action would be. So this required a lot of prototyping first, how the app should look. These guys don't know how to read very well. How does the patient feel coming and talking to a doctor in Dhaka? So there was a lot of prototyping that went up, and it's still going on. I'm out of time. I'll finish in 30 seconds. You can see a bit of evolution of the app where a lot of it was textual, and gradually you kind of need to base on the tests and the feedback that you get from your users. Again, when you're testing your prototype, you have to go back to observe. You don't say that, hey, do you like this? Hey, isn't this awesome? You just leave it there and you just watch, sit and watch, and you see what people do with it. Because when you ask them, you come from a City, you're so nice to dress, so you're gonna say, oh, this is all. And it's an ongoing process. So what you see on the right is actually another prototype, service prototype, where we have our own kiosk, where it's not the medicine fellow who provides the service, it's we, our office provides the service. That's another version of the service that we're trying to do. So again, I think for me, the biggest challenge is not converging. I can quickly see, oh, these are the constraints, this is too expensive, I don't have a developer who can make that. For me, the biggest challenge is trying to be creative. And I mean, I'm kind of not on the design team at HKS, so how do I keep my creative muscles moving? Sometimes I try to take notes by drawing them. So this is from a lecture that's talking about how host and host society, where people use host, versus a cloud society, where you have to farm using clouds can affect gender norms. Because even after a woman has a baby, she can still farm, but in a cloud society, she can go on the farm. So you know, trying to be visual again kind of keeps your creative muscles moving. And this is like a simple prototype. This is basically paper. But again, it's better than one. So that's all I have. So I think like my message to everyone is, you know, start thinking design, start thinking creatively, because everything is design. Thank you.
She is passionate about international development and plans for a career addressing poverty challenges using business, technology, and design. Her talk is titled Design Thinking for Everyone.
I mentioned how much effort Robert put in making sure he gets our things right. And we all, being from many different international countries, really appreciate that. So thank you, everyone. It's quite interesting.
Our first fantastic speaker tonight is Shami Kuthis. Shami is a Dubin Fellow, an MPAID candidate here at the Kennedy School, and an MBA candidate at the Stanford Graduate School of Business. Shami was raised in Bangladesh, an MIT educated environmental engineer.